The search for the remaining orbs continues, and having followed the tragic tale of Kai and Michelle's ill-fated interspecies tryst through to its conclusion, the party set out to sea to try and use Lorelei's harp to reach the underwater nation of Nautica, where they hope to uncover some clues as to the whereabouts of the giant pearl that sank beneath the waves. What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 26 of the Ultimate Let's Play Dragon Quest XI. So yeah, last time we completed the storyline involving Michelle the Mermaid and Kai. Very sad ending, unfortunately. But now we must move on. We've gotten Lorelei's harp, so we have the means of getting to the underwater village of Nautica. But I believe this episode, we're going to be doing a bit of exploring on the high seas, and we're gonna be doing a bit of island hopping to try and get some extra goodies today. So we're gonna be deviating from the main storyline for just one episode, and then I think come the next episode is when we'll finally hit Nautica. And I know I probably could have just zoomed out, but I usually like to take this time to explain what we're gonna do for the episode here, just so we're ready for the action that's to come. And now, once I get my bearings, I'll decide how I'm going to approach this. Because I believe one of the reasons why I'm doing this is because if I hit all these certain islands, the Insula Islands, I believe, that is actually going to get an accomplishment, I believe, an accolade. And plus, I think it's worthwhile searching these islands for anything extra. What I'm going to do here, I want to get to the Strand. Right now, I'm gonna just take a shortcut here and warp there. Yeah, the boat will come with us, so there's no need to worry. Okay, and then we'll just talk to Dave to get right back on the boat. Except he is this way. And it's possible I may be running some pretty strong enemies. I know one of the islands that I'm planning to visit today is going to be filled with nothing but the slime enemies. And there we can find the rare liquid metal slime. If we're lucky enough to encounter and kill one of those, well, then we will really be in business in terms of experience. Because they'll give out like 10,000 experience per. And that'll level up everybody at least once. So, first place I'm going to go is that island directly south to us, or just a tad east. So let's go ahead and head there. I believe that's called Insula Incognita. Right here. But first, as expected, I'm going to have to be dealing with a few battles. I think what I'm going to do here is actually swap out Jade for Silvando. So we have some power to hit some multiple targets here. I just love this attack Starburst throw, just how powerful it is. Took everybody out one shot.
Oh yeah.
And just like that, Eric gets a level up. He's got 12 points now. And Serena levels up as well. She's got, well, only 3 points right now, so I probably can't do anything with her. But maybe I can do something with Eric. And go back into the Guile section or start working on these things. I need one more point for Power Throw, or 4 more points for Tumerang. I think I'm going to focus on Tumerang first. I could burn a Sea of Skill and get Power Throw right now, but I'm going to hold one more, because, like I said, we could be coming up on an island with a liquid metal slime, and if that's the case, bing, bang, boom, I kill one of those. I'm lucky enough to do so, and we're in business. Anyways, we'll disembark here on Insula Incognita, I believe. Yep, this is Insula Incognita. Okay, and I think there's probably going to be some tough enemies here. This is not the Slime Island, by the way. But there's one treasure I think that I can get, and I'll be keeping my eye out for any kind of shiny stuff as well. But I believe this island is also home to like some trolls and things like that. So I gotta be careful. Thankfully, the only time I'm gonna be dealing with random battles is if I am on the water. And like already, I see the trolls over there. I might hold off on fighting one of them. And we just found an Yggdrasil leaf. Yeah, this is one of the reasons why we came here. This spot will spawn Yggdrasil leaves. Alright, let's fight this guy. Oh jeez, he brought some backup and some serious backup. And what a time to get a pep up here. I'm not gonna bother with that. Let's just go ahead and hit him with a zap. We'll go for the trolls. I'm not too worried about the brownies. Okay. But you're definitely gonna want to hit him with a starburst throw.
Heads up!
Yeah, already the brownie's done. Let's see. What can I do? Let's try to see if whack works on these guys. Nope. Figures worth a try. And let's try. No one did. We'll just try the lashings of love. I just don't want to risk his head taking it. Up, he fell. That probably would have been a critical hit had that hit.
Yeah.
Alright. So now he's got a little bit of a kick here. So we're gonna need a little bit more power to take this guy out. Let's zap him. And they're both still alive. Crackle. And both of them go down. That's probably gonna be a good amount of experience there. Almost 1,000. I think that was definitely worthwhile. Now, the other reason why we're here is a treasure chest. It's somewhere around here. And yes, I am using a map. Aha! You can climb up here. Climb up these ledges. And just jump these. And I guess, yep, I see the treasure chest right there. And what do we got here? We've got recipe book, crafting comforting clothing. I can make robes of serenity. Okay. Well, let's pull out the forge and let's see what that's going to take. And if it's going to be worthwhile making any. I need one fairy fluff, one fresh water, and one purple eye. Because slowly... Yeah, actually, Silvando has one of these equipped right now. So if I were to use one of these, yeah, I'll take a small hit in defense, but I will be able to restore HP in combat. So you know what? I'll make one. Maybe I'll give it to Serena or something. Always good to have the healer in tip-top shape. And I got these quadra bashes. I might as well use them. Okay, that was not actually where I wanted to go with that one. But I overshot one. Overshot that one, too. Guess I'm just going to use my regular bashes from here on out. But maybe these good scores will... make it worthwhile. They'll override the mistakes. Good, I was hoping to get at least a plus one out of that. You know what, that's fine. So now, let's see. This could also be good for Veronica. Let's see. This will take out her. This might actually be worthwhile for giving to... You know, I'll give it to Serena. If she's got to use magic in combat, that may help her out a little bit, because that's very low. Hardly worthwhile. Okay. Oh, and I see a mining spot over here. I'll go ahead and grab that. Get some iron, some silver, and more silver. Not a bad haul. Okay. And I think we're done here, so I'm just going to go ahead and head back to the ship. And we'll zoom on over to the next island. Okay, we're coming, David. We're almost there. And we did get an Idrisil leaf out of this, so it was definitely worthwhile coming here. Okay, next up on my thing here. Orientalis, so we're going to be heading northwest. Is there an easier way to get there? I don't think so. I could just zoom back to Honolulu and just head straight up that way, but you know what? We'll just take the long way here. Yeah, we'll have to fight some enemies. But they're too stunned to move, so you know what? I'll let them go. Sometimes you just gotta pick your battles. I don't want to burn too much of my MP doing this stuff. I don't know when's the next time I'm going to be able to get a chance to heal at all. I'm going to be checking, have to check my map a few times as we go through the mists and the fog, trying to get onto the other side of the world here. Miasmas, I'm going to have to fight these guys, it looks like. Thank you, Eric. I'm so glad I taught you that move, and you're not too far away from another good attack as well. Pretty soon he's going to have all his boomerang abilities. He'll be the boomerang master. Yeah, I know there's an island to the east here, but I'm going to take care of that last. I'm going to just kind of go in a circle around the world here. Or war griffins, okay. It's kind of like a falcon slash. Starting to use that move like a crutch here. Don't have a magic barrier? Well, I guess I'll just attack with the claws then. Good work, Rab.
Who else wants some?
Okay, where are we now? We're up, just gotta turn a little bit this way. Up. I see the island. Albeit a small one, but actually this is the island that has nothing but the slime, so I'm gonna be keeping an eye out for those liquid metal slimes. Now, I'm not sure if there's anything else to see here. But I'm gonna be just looking around here. I also see some king slimes, which can be dangerous. And when a group of slimes appear like this, they could merge together to form a king slime. That was probably a waste of a throw like that.
Not bad at all.
Yeah, those guys would have transformed, because they're giving out quite a lot of experience. Now, is there anything worthwhile here? And I'm going to fight some random enemies, just in case a liquid metal slime shows up. And just to play it safe, I'm going to put Jade back in the lineup. Because I may be using her Thunder Thrust. Well, you can use your Ooze Bruiser. This is a perfect opportunity to use that move. Best used against slime enemies.
Another one bites the dust.
I actually guess there is something we can get here. This guy has got to cross this bridge, it looks like. Maybe I'll fight one of these King Slimes just to show you what it's like. But he's going to get the first attack on us. Oof. Yeah, this guy's packing a punch. Oh, you know Snub? What does that do? Oh, this guy can attack twice per turn. Let's try a Thunder Thrust.
Thunder Thrust!
Missed. You missed. Zam him.
Surrender your soul!
I blocked it. Well, we'll try Thunder Thrust one more time. Bullseye! But he's still alive. Okay, Snub wore off. That time he missed Eric. Yeah, those guys can be tricky.
Another day, another victory.
And we got a slime drop, which I think we can use to make a slime crown. Let's have Serena heal us. And there's a treasure chest, but we need the key to open it, and I think it's a special key that I need, so I can't get it right now. But it looks like I can get some more mining equipment, and I see a treasure chest over there I wonder if I can grab. Iron, silver, and silver. Not a bad haul. Okay, now can I... Is there a way to get up there? Get back onto dry land here. I unfortunately have not found a liquid metal slime yet, and that's unfortunate. I don't know if it's gotta be a certain time of the day or what. Hell, even a metal slime, a regular metal slime, would still be good. Still give you a couple grand in terms of experience. Okay, I think I just gotta go over here. And, there's the treasure chest. What is it gonna give me? A slime crown. How about that? Now, what does this slime crown do? I can't wear it, apparently. Let's go into the equipment thing here. Who can wear it? Not you. Can Eric wear it? Or is this a... I thought for a second it was going to be an accessory, but it's not. I better look through my inventory here. Where is that slime crown? It's not falling under equipment there. Weird. The regal regalia of one of the slime worlds, great and good. They sell it for 2,500, but apparently it's not equipment, so I'm guessing I'm just going to have to sell it for money. Which, I guess, is okay. It's sold for a bit more, though. But what can you do? Ooh, mini metal. That wasn't even in my notes, and I just found that on a whim. Well, whatever, I'll take it. Sometimes you just get lucky with those. I don't know if all the mini mills are in fixed locations, or you can get random ones sometimes. I really don't know, but I'm pretty sure you don't need to find them all to get all the goodies out there. But if you can get a good number of them, I think the magic number is like 100 or so, which I think is what you need for the ultimate prize. Don't quote me on that, but I believe in practice that's, I think, what it was. Yeah, when they gang up like this, you gotta be ready for a possible slime crown, so. He's gonna keep calling for backup. And I think once 8 pop up on the field, then you're in trouble. So let's just zap him. Right, we left one standing. We got a slime drop and a medicinal herb out of that one. Yeah, I'm sorry to say, no liquid metal slimes around here, which is unfortunate. Maybe I could fight one of these guys. Maybe they'll make one of them show up. I don't know. Nope, just heal slimes. Now, great time for a critical hit.
Ah, not bad.
See a sparkly. I'll go ahead and grab that before we leave. Yeah, but that's unfortunate. I was really hoping to find a liquid metal slime here somewhere. And I know they're around here, because I've, in the past, come across them here. If you're lucky enough to defeat one, yeah, it's like 10,000 experience. Tiny tortoise shell. You guys let me down today. See, I don't think you actually see them on the map. They'll just appear as cohorts to the other enemies. Then again, I could be mistaken on that, but that has been common practice in my runs in the past. Okay, we're done here. Maybe I'll come back and look for these guys again. So now we're going to be heading to the island on the northernmost point of the map. No, not that one. I am curious to see what it is. This guy's gonna get in my way. You know what? I think I'm gonna put Eric away for a little while, bring in Veronica.
Need a little help?
Oh, the fire attack. Okay, now you're getting on my bad side here. I'll go ahead and zap you two. One down. Carry you. Try propeller blade on this otter shambles. Oh, that's a nifty attack. Alright. Just give him a frizzle and burn him. Down he goes. But we're gonna need a healing from Serene after that one. Let's see, can we heal all? I don't know if there's anything worthwhile over here. really see as far where I can even disembark. Actually, before we hit that northern island, I'm going to show you what we can do with Lorelei's harp here. See that glowing glowing column right there? I will demonstrate what Lorelei's harp will do. It'll actually take us under the water. Wonder when she's going to learn Boom, which is the more powerful version of Bang. So I'm going to do a bit more damage than that. So he just healed himself. Oh, beautiful.
Propeller blade!
That doesn't really do much. Oh, here goes that water attack. Falcon Slash. Alright. So yeah, we will only be able to use this column if we have Lorelei's harp. So I'm going to go ahead and use it. I play Lorelei's harp. It's going to take me under the water. And it's actually going to warp me. This particular one is going to warp me. And here we can find another island, which is within the mainland here. Right here, as a matter of fact. We'll disembark here. I could have sworn that there was an island or a spot where we can rest here. Must got a few new enemies, it looks like. I don't know if I'm in the best condition to fight them just now. There's another magic door, which we don't have the means of getting yet, unfortunately. I actually think there's another mini metal around here. Yeah, we can't get that yet. I'm playing a little avoidance here because I'm not sure of how strong these enemies are. I know there's something. Was that it? Yeah, I see it right here. Yep, there's the main metal I was looking for. Okay. You know what? I'll fight just one of these guys just to see what they're about. This is a Mastodon. So it's kind of like one of those other monsters we were dealing with back in Port of Valor. Let's burn him. I wonder if I can just whack this guy. Nope, didn't work. Alright, let's try Thunder Thrust. So far, get critical. That's the risk you take. It's either critical or it's a miss. There's no in between. Oof. Ouch, that hurt. Yikes. Whew, that was close.
Well, that was easy.
And Silvano's going to get a level up. I don't think he's got... He's only got 5 points, so I'm just going to sit on those. But yeah, I'm not going to risk fighting these guys anymore. And I'm actually going the wrong way. But quick, heals up. Yeah, Serena just had to burn a lot of her magic to get us healed. But we got what we came for, so let's get the hell out of here. And back to the open seas we go, and back to our original destination, which was, I believe this is, the next one is Insula Borealis. This is our next port of call here. We'll just follow the coast here. We'll eventually be exploring this part of the world here. Ooh, and we got a couple strong ones here. Immediately throwing up magic barrier. We're gonna have to rely on our physical attacks. Because that's a Dithon that we're dealing with. Let's see what Bang does.
Don't say I didn't warn you.
Well, we're still able to get through with, so good. Oh no, Veronica's poisoned. Yeah, I'm in kind of a risky lineup here because I don't have a healer. Alright. Let's heal up. Okay, and you know what? Let's change lineup here. Get Eric back in here. I'll put Serena in. We'll take Rab out, we'll keep Veronica in, get our original four in there. I think that should do for now. And we are knocking on the door of our next destination, this small island right here. Yes, I do want to disembark here. Thank you. The bridge to get to that, and that guy looks pretty fierce. I don't think I'm ready to take him on yet. I'm kind of treading cautiously here. That's a Corallosis that I'm seeing here. I know I've fought those guys before. I thought I saw something shiny up there, but no, that was just the sky. Yeah, there's a shininess over here. Handful of glass spritz. There's a guy here. Oh, wait, you world walker. I'm fishing for a tribute fit for a queen. Apparently he doesn't want to share his bounty, so I'll go ahead and nab this bit of ore over here. Blue iron, a couple pieces of silver ore here. I could have sworn there was more stuff over here. so I'm not getting trailed by anybody. Okay, I see something over there. I think I can walk over there, hopefully without triggering that fight. Get some shininess over here. Celestial Sky, again, still not quite what I'm looking for here. I may be mistaken. I thought there was going to be something here. Alright. Alright, let's get out of here. I thought there was going to be more. Somewhere I can't really see where everything is. I want another map here. I guess I'm gonna be checking out this part of the continent here. Pull up my map again here. Yeah, I'm actually looking at a secondary map on my other screen here as we try to get through this little gauntlet of enemies. Okay, Veronica's pissed. Yeah, just use regular attack. Don't want you to burn any more MP. Especially when you don't have the MP to do so. You know what? We'll go ahead and unleash Arborius' Blessing.
We of Arborius swear to protect you. While we live, none shall defeat you.
So we'll get some MP and HP regeneration here. Hopefully, can ward off a little bit from that attack. Oh, yeah, I'm getting quite a bit back. Dude, that hurt. You know, just go ahead and heal yourself here. Guy a bit more oomph here. Finally he goes down thanks to a Falcon Slash. Alright. I wonder how close is everyone to leveling up here. Looks like Savannah's got the longest to go here. Well, Jade's gonna level up on her next battle, guaranteed, pretty much. She's only 86 points away. We're not gonna take this one just yet, I don't think. Or maybe we can as a little shortcut. I'll try it. Let's see where it takes me. Yeah, I can't get out. So that was a little shortcut. Which way do I want to go here? There's a Viking hideout. Might as well just check it out. I don't think we're going to be coming here just yet, but there may be some stuff we can possibly look at later. Anyway, we're in the Sniffleheim region. Again, we'll be coming here later on. Get ourselves a mini metal. And I don't think we're going to be doing anything else here. We could, instant heal. How about that? Except that I don't need to save right now. I kind of want to finish this island hopping before we end the episode here. So that's all we're going to do here. And the other little crevice is going to take us to Sniffleheim proper, but we're not going to go there just yet. Instead, we're going to head out to this little island just to the southwest or southeast here. So make our way through the Arctic Ocean here. All right, we've got all of our power back, so let's just unleash on these guys. Let's unleash your most powerful magic here. Give him a zap. You've got a little bit of magic, so why don't you go ahead and try whoosh.
And don't come back!
Combined effort. And Jade levels up. She has 8 points. Can I do anything with her? She can learn Deliverance. She can learn Party Pooper. I could give her plus 10 there. Or what happens if I go this way? Up the Charm or up the Resilience? You know what? Let's go ahead and give her the Resilience just for now. I can learn the attacks later on. Let's check out this island here. Okay, now here. Insula Algarim, and then after this, I think there's just one more island to visit. So we got a bunch of flying enemies gonna try and dive bomb us here. So let's just stay out of their way. I think we need to go down this path anyway. Shininess over here. Might as well grab it for some forging items. Fairy Fluff, good. Narspicious, okay. Narspicious, okay. Alright. I think there's something on this side here. It's a War Griffin, if I'm not mistaken. Oh. Yeah, this guy was right on my ass, so I had to fight him. Okay, now, I gotta be careful, because I think these enemies, the Pteranodons, they have whack. So if I don't take them out quickly, and they hit me with whack, that's an instant kill. Luckily, Serena has Zing, and I think I have Zing as well. I've got a Haze Condor here as well. Thankfully, these guys look like they go down pretty easily. So I'll just throw the bang. He is kind of what I can deal with. Yeah. She's not... Yeah, Serena's not really good as an attacker. but she is a vital part of our team.
Easy.
I'll get some twisted talons from that one. There's the treasure chest. Okay. And we got ourselves a Lucida shard. I think that's a rare forging item. So that could come in handy later on as part of a more advanced recipe. But I'm going to have a few war griffins to deal with. I've already been dealing with a few of these. Freeze them out of the sky here. Wow, almost now doing triple digit damage, but here comes the magic barrier. That's just going to increase their defense against magic, though. I don't think it's going to work against Starburst throw, though. Bye-bye. 1, 2, 3.
Veronica wins again.
And Eric's going to get a level up. And he got 4 skill points, which is exactly what I think he needed. I didn't realize Rab... Was that Eric or Rab that... No, it was Rab that got the points. He leveled up, not Eric. Unless I misread something. I must have. I could teach him, Oh, he could lose can opener. I need 1 point for that. I could give him a strength boost, or a magical mending boost, or a magical might boost. I'm probably going to want to go this route, because I'm not really using a lot of physical attacks with Rab. And this could give me a new pet power as well. So actually, I'm going to give Rab one of my seeds of skill. As soon as I find it. Let me go ahead and reorganize everything here. Seed of skill. I will give 1 to Rab. Okay, now... Rab will learn Caster Sugar. Rab and Jade learn new pet power, Rush of Blood. Okay, and we got an accolade for 10 of Rab's pals, but that War Griffin was right on top of us. So we're going to have to fight. So you know what, Rab? We're going to take... Veronica's place here. And you know what? We'll bring in Jay to take on Serena's place. Get the two of you back in. We'll go ahead and try the Scorch and Sweep on these guys.
Nice.
Just kick some fire at the enemies. Give this guy a Zam.
Surrender your soul.
All right, Veronica's gonna get a level up, and she's got 3 points, not enough to do anything with, so not right now. I think we're done here for now. I just gotta... Just take a direct shot right to the boat. And hopefully avoid these guys. Well, I'll grab this shiny while I'm here. More royal soil. How many... And that he's come where was right on me. Hopefully these guys are easy enough to kill. Good work, team.
And stay down.
All right, I level up, and I'm going to learn a new spell. Now I have Zing. Excellent. So I can revive now. And I have 10 power points to use here. I could go Giga Slash once to get 25 points. Up my critical hit chance. Can learn dual wielding. Maybe I should have saved my... skill seeds for this, because I just need to, I'm basically 2 points shy of it. I could learn poof, or could increase my deafness. I guess I'll hold for now. Okay, I'd like to get off this island now. And I'm getting all turned around here. These guys attack me from behind. Just get out of my way here. I'm not gonna run from any battles unless I'm getting the preemptive strike. Luckily the Raven Lunatic thought better and flew the coop. Because yeah, Eric's actually getting a little weak here. I may need to call in Serena to do us some healing. Done here, Dave. Get us out of here. Alright, now we got one more island to visit, and it's just the southwest. Insula Occidentis. I believe that's it right over there. Unfortunately, I got one last obstacle to get past here. Eric's only got one starburst throw left. So I need to pull him out soon.
Never in doubt.
Oh, beautiful critical. Just what I needed. Glad he didn't use that water attack.
Aha, Kraken! Surrender your soul!
Alright. I don't know why we're missing all these attacks all of a sudden, but this should finish him off. Alright, down he goes.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, good. Eric got his level up and got his MP back. Does he have enough points to work? He's got 15 points. One more for Tomb Rank. So, you know what? I have one last. Let me dock first, and I'll give Eric my last scene of skill so he can learn Tomb Rank. Yep, we've awarded for making port to each of the many islands scattered throughout the world. And that guy looks like a fun beast to deal with. Anyways, I have a sea of skill, one left. Give it to Eric. And now we'll let him learn the Tomerang ability. Pretty soon he's going to open up this part of his tree there. Tomerang. Alright. Now, not exactly sure how much power it's got on it. I guess we'll find out soon enough. Let me see what I gotta do here. Looks like there's actually an inn I can reach. I knew there was an inn on one of these islands, and it just so happens to be on the very last one I check out. So anyways, let's explore this island. That's another one of those areas where I need a key to get the treasure. This is a Jowler. It's gonna get an opening attack on us. Okay, it's doing 60 damage.
Oh, yeah!
Well, this is probably not the best time to test out Tomerang, but let's give it a shot. Yeah, because it hits twice all enemies. That counter card works pretty well too.
Surrender your soul!
Got him. And Serena's going to get a level up and a new spell. Now she's got the more heal spell. Good. Yeah, so it's definitely worthwhile doing all this extra exploring because all my guys are learning, are getting more powers they can use here. And I guess I'll go ahead and give her the recovery. She could always use that, especially when we're battling a lot, like today. What the hell is this? Oh, got some orcsware as well. So these are all the spiked hairs. Well, so let's try tomb rank on these guys. Not bad. That's a beautiful kick there. Gee. Oh boy. Tried to snooze on me there. Didn't work. So now does it zap you into oblivion? Some healing after this guy.
Kraken!
Alright. I think we're probably going to want to take a little nap here. Just restore the rest and finish up our exploration. We're lucky to find this little cabin. Alright, well, and let's see. An adventurer, are you? You know if we get folks like you come near. This sounds the place for hermits, exiles, and other assorted outcasts. When I was younger, I got up to sorts, pirating, pillaging, and the like. Now I spend me days just staring out to sea. This ain't the place for a globetrotting traveler like you. I reckon it's high time you were on your way. Can I take a rest, though? Thank you. There's just a little bit left to get here at the moment. There's something in the back here. One of these pots, maybe. Found another mini mel. Nice. Again, this is one that was not in my notes here. Anything else? Let's check this barrel. I've got a little bit more gold. Excellent. So what are we at now? We're almost at 10,000 gold. Very nice. All right. Oh, and I see a shiny. Let's pick that up before we head off. Silk Blossom. Okay. And are we close to leveling up at all? No. I think we've done enough at this rate. I think we're done battling. We've explored all the islands that are to be explored. And actually, I think what we'll do, we'll just head back to Honolulu for now. We'll heal up and save up, and then we'll set up for the next episode, which we'll be heading to Nautica. So we'll say Nautica is going to be quite the adventure when we get there. Alright, so yeah, we got a lot. It didn't seem like a lot in terms of storyline progress, but we did get quite a bit done. We learned a few new tricks and spells, which are definitely going to come in handy later on. We're pretty far away from any kind of level up, so probably won't be seeing any in the next episode unless we do a hell of a lot of fighting. But, you never know until we get there. But I know since we're going to be eventually hitting a new town, there's going to be a lot more exploring, which is probably going to be... So yeah, next episode may just very well be another heavy exploring episode. We'll be actually heading underwater for the next episode. And that's going to be quite interesting. We'll see how all that turns out. How Laura Lies Harp will allow us to access this underwater kingdom. But for now, it's time to call it quits, and like I said, next episode we'll be heading to Nautica. So until then, this is T.U.G saying be smart, be safe, Have fun. Later, gamers.